Merging physicality with non-physicality. We are always interested in how the energies are affecting you in any given moment. And as you know, now more than ever, there are energies that are affecting you as an individual, that are affecting the human collective, and that affect Mother Earth. You are swimming in an ocean of energies all the time, and sometimes certain energies get amplified, because they have greater significance in that particular moment for humanity. And when you go through something as a collective that affects you, there are more energies sent to support you. Think of how an energy healer works. They have someone who comes to them with some sort of physical or emotional ailment. And the energy healer taps into the energies that will best assist the person who has come to them. The person with the ailments is the one who summoned the energies in the first place. However, they have been unable to receive those energies themselves. So the healer is called upon to act as the conduit. That is what you are all doing for humanity, for yourselves and for Mother Earth. You are the conduits for all the energies that have been summoned, because you are open and sensitive. You are taking care of yourselves enough to be able to let those energies run through your physical bodies. This can be taxing on the committed light worker. Therefore, you are constantly being called upon to be the committed light worker. We are reminding you again, you need to take care of yourselves by hydrating, by clearing your negative emotions and negative thoughts. You need to rest, to meditate, and to spend time in nature. You need to take care of your relationships and yourself, including your diet, and when you do all of that, the reward is a healthier you. Also, by running those energies through your physical body, you get more to play with. You get to enjoy the ride that everyone there on Earth is taking to the fifth density, with a sneak preview of what everyone will be experiencing at the completion of the shift. If you are receiving this message, then yes, you are a light worker, and yes, you have been called upon to be the committed one. It does not have to be any more complicated than that. Take care of yourselves and be the conduits for the higher frequency energies that are coming in and that are around you, and you will lead a happy and healthy life. You will also be of service to everyone else there on Earth, whether they know it or not. While you may not win any awards for being conduits of higher frequency energies, you will get to feel those energies first, and you will recognize what is being created for humanity on the physical level. And there is so much more to come for humanity, even in the fourth density. Therefore, do not concern yourself about which future you are all headed for. Trust that you are on an ascension journey. And therefore, all of planet Earth is on an upward spiral. And know that there is a plan for everything to work out for everyone. You are a key component in that plan. Remember that and honor yourselves as the committed light workers that you truly are. As you embrace every experience as it comes your way, you make it easier for yourselves to ascend. And anything that you resist, you will need to continue to experience until you make peace with it. While making peace with everything may sound insignificant compared to the ascension of your consciousness, ask yourself the question, can you do that right now? Be honest with yourself when you get your answer. Can you make peace with everything in your life and all the people in your life? Can you make peace with the world and everything that is happening in the world? Can you make peace with the fact that other people think and believe differently, have different views to your own? That is your work. You know when you are not at peace because of your thoughts, feelings, and judgments. Those are your clues as to what you must work on next. And for some of you, those clues have been popping up for decades. but you were unaware that it was your work to make peace with those things. Perhaps you thought it was your work to change those things. As soon as you find yourself asking someone else to change for you, that is when you know you have not made peace with this person, with how they are and what they are saying, thinking, and feeling. Now, how do you do it? How do you get to that place? Firstly, start by acknowledging to yourself that everything serves a purpose, just as it is. If Source approves of everything as it is and everyone as they are, and your ascension is about going home to Source and becoming one with Source, which it is, then you must seek to understand how all of it is perfect, just as it is. By letting go of your resistance, you will stop being triggered. Then you can be at peace and live with that knowing that everything is all right, and it is getting better. This you can trust and have faith in, and you can believe and know this because it is true. How could you be headed for a huge cataclysm, with annihilation for everyone and everything? Remember, everything is in perfect order, and that your only job is to be yourself. You complete the puzzle of Source by being you, because no one else can be you except you, and all parts are needed. All pieces of the puzzle are required in order to complete the puzzle. That is what we are all doing, no matter where we are, no matter which density we inhabit. When you realize that all you must do is be at peace with everything and be yourself, ascension becomes so much easier, and your life gets so much simpler and potentially more enjoyable. We know that there are many more people awakening every day, and that those of you who are awake are helping them in so many ways. It is our knowing that more people will be looking within themselves, with the prompting of their guides and the people who are closest to them. Because it is so necessary for people to stop looking outside of themselves for what is wrong in their lives and to start looking within. The emotions that people feel get louder and louder until they pay attention to them. Those emotions are indicating to someone to pay attention that there is still more work to do. Therefore, those of you who have people in your lives that you know still have much introspection to do, you are being called upon to be gentle with them. You are being asked to guide them while also nurturing them through the experience. Because as you all know, feeling those emotions is challenging to say the least. Buried emotions coming to the surface after decades can be overwhelming, wreaking havoc on someone's life and their relationships. You, as the awakened collective, have that responsibility to those around you, to maintain your stability no matter what they are going through, no matter what they are purging, no matter how hard it is for you to stay by their side. This is also incredibly challenging work that you have given yourselves. Therefore, you have chosen to awaken first, to do the work yourselves. It was all to prepare you for these moments. You know you love the people who are closest to you in your lives, and you know you love them enough to stay by them, even when they are experiencing the worst of the emotional purging. However, you also have enough experience with that process to know that you were not at your best when you were doing that purging. The people around you will not be at their best to such an extent that they may try to force you out of their lives. That is when you remember that your spiritual evolution is about forgiveness, compassion, and unconditional love. You will help heal your loved ones by being love, rather than just knowing it as a philosophy or a theory. The energies coming in until the end of 2022 will continue to raise in speed, and the speed of energies coming in determine how long a person keeps those negative emotions buried. We are selecting the right timing to deliver to humanity energies that will assist you to remember who you have been in the higher realms, especially the non-physical ones. We know that you have an existence prior to incarnating there on Earth in the flesh. Most of you know this as well, and you may have some ideas about who and what you have been in the non-physical densities of this universe. The energies being prepared for you right now will help you to have experiences where you are remembering what it was like to be those versions of yourselves that were non-physical. You need to know it intellectually and to also experience it innately. You need to have the experience of it in your bodies in order for it to feel true to you. This lifetime, in many ways, is about merging the non-physical with the physical for all of you, because for far too long the physical has been overemphasized and the non-physical has been believed to be somewhere far off in the ethers and inaccessible to the physical being on Earth. However, that is now changing, as you all come to know and fully embrace the truth that there is no separation. Activating more of your non-physical selves will happen in a variety of ways. This will be one of the most critical ways for you to merge the non-physical with the physical. You are there to unite the galaxy, to bring heaven to earth, to know yourselves as source energy beings. And these are no small tasks that you have taken on in this lifetime. That is why it is taking longer than many of you would like. However, now that you are so awake and so aware of who you really are, and who you have been, it does not have to take much longer. You can also grant yourselves more access to these experiences by intending to bring back more of that information from your astral travels. You can have more of the experiences of Source flowing through you in your waking state as well. All you need to do is to intend to see the world through the eyes of Source. You can also ask yourselves how you can express yourselves in any given situation as Source. You can be the love of Source in the flesh that you always intended to be in this lifetime. It is also the most satisfying way to be while in a physical body of any kind, on any planet, in any star system. Merging these two realms will bring you to the greatest satisfaction, the greatest fulfillment, and the greatest experiences that you can have. This is why we are very excited about this project that we are working on, and we know that so many of you are excited to experience more of yourselves. All you need to do is accept the help that we are giving. Trust, relax, and let it all happen. Let it all in. You are the ones to change what it means to be human there on Earth, because you are awake, and because you are so far along on your journey. As we have been exploring many possible timelines for humanity there on Earth, we have seen some beautiful futures for all of you. But the future is especially bright for those of you who have owned that you have issues, that you have trauma, that you have negative emotions, that you do not always allow yourselves to feel. You are the ones who understand that in order to evolve and become more of who you really are, there is a certain amount of self-awareness, self-reflection, and work on the self that must occur. Therefore, you are the ones who lead humanity into the better-feeling futures by first not feeling very good at all. Now that may seem like a paradox to you, but it is absolutely the case. We must clean out the old to allow the new in. And in this case, the new that we are referring to is higher frequency energy. We are talking about letting in upgrades, activations, downloads and attunements, all of which are available to you. However, you do not always let them in, and you cannot let them in if you are in denial. You cannot let them in if you are offering a low vibration that you are completely unaware of. Therefore, we prescribe to all of you regular check-ins. Everything you need to know can be discovered when you take the time to check in with the seven chakras in your body. Your seven main chakras are where you are going to feel the vast majority of what you need to feel before you get to those higher frequency energies running through you. Many wise people say that a person who is experiencing a very bad place must hit rock bottom before coming back up again. Because when you hit rock bottom, you have no other option but to feel what you are feeling, as you have run out of defense mechanisms, distractions, and things to escape into. You are left to face yourself, a person you are supposed to be, loving, honoring, and respecting. It is by first acknowledging where you are that you can find your way to where you are going. Do yourselves a favor. Do not live for one moment in denial of what is going on inside of you, because you are not doing yourself or anyone any good by pretending that everything is all right when it truly is not. And do not be afraid to communicate to those around you what you are going through, because they will surprise you oftentimes with compassion, support, and kindness. There are way more empaths on Earth with you today than there have ever been in all of human history, and empathy is a superpower. It is those of you who feel that truly have access to all your power, and the more you feel, the better. The more you feel, the sooner you get to choose what you are going to feel in the next moment, and the next, and the next. We are very satisfied with your progress. You truly are operating as a collective already while in your physical form. You really are not separate from any of the beings who are helping you. And what we see happening there on Earth is more and more people are opening up to the help that is always available to them. People are recognizing the significance of a sign or a synchronicity, and people are more likely to follow their internal intuitive guidance, and this is raising the vibration of the consciousness there on Earth. You all who are awake are leading humanity in these ways. You are becoming more likely to tell others about your experiences, and as you do so, you help so many to understand what they have been experiencing. You can normalize a synchronicity for another person by telling them what you know the synchronicity means to you. Those who have yet to awaken are sometimes even afraid of the synchronicities they experience. And so this is another way in which the awakened collective is helping humanity. Continue to tell your stories, write your books, your blogs, and make your videos, because you make it easier for others to find you and what you have to share, what you have come to know. Those people who have become disillusioned to some extent by the beliefs they were raised on are looking for guidance from those who have the wisdom within them. Wisdom comes from experience, and all of you, because of the choices you have made, have had more experiences than the average person has. Therefore, you have much to offer them. You can show others the way to their internal guidance by demonstrating how you do it, what you look for and listen for, and you will find that more people are fascinated by those signs and symbols than you may think. You cannot judge a book by its cover, and you cannot tell by someone's outward appearance whether they are open to the types of beliefs that you hold to be true. Some of you are afraid to be mocked or laughed at, and certainly there are those who will do that, and you have no control over that. However, you always have control over how you respond to people. Let your confidence come from knowing who you really are at your core, and knowing that everyone else is also a source energy being, just playing their part, just playing the role that you ask them to play. And then nothing will shake your confidence in your truth. When you get to that point and have that certainty, people respond to you differently. People respond differently when you are not looking for their approval, and when you do not care whether they believe in what you are saying. The best way to demonstrate to someone else how the universe works is to live by those truths that you have come to know to be true. Let them see you in action, and then describe to them what is happening and how you are doing it, how you are manifesting the experiences you want to have. Those of you who have been brave enough to put yourselves out there and speak your truth are helping to raise the level of consciousness there on Earth. We are always looking to help, always looking to do our part to bring the consciousness of this universe to a higher level. However, understand that there must be a balance between moving towards what we are all inevitably becoming and taking that time to reflect on how far we have already come and what we have already created. No matter where you are in your life right now, you can benefit from more of this kind of balance in your lives and in your beingness. As much as you are eagerly awaiting the next upgrade, the next activation, the next giant leap forward in your consciousness evolution, you must take time out to appreciate the beautiful world you have co-created. And even though it is challenging at times to find the beauty on your world, that is more reason to be putting your effort and attention on getting to that place of appreciation for what already is. You must bring those two sides of yourselves together, the side that is always striving for more, and the side that just wants to kick back, relax, and do nothing. You want there to be harmony between the creative aspect of you and the part of you that feels satisfied with what already is in your lives and on your world. Striking that balance makes you a better creator being. It makes all your effort towards manifestation more effective and faster. There must be balance between doing and not doing, between masculine and feminine, between desire and appreciation, or else you will always feel overwhelmed or feel stagnant. Checking in is the key in determining what you need to strike that balance. Look at your current energy level. Take into consideration what you genuinely desire in the moment you are in, or else your decision will be determined by programming. You also want to break free from parental, societal, and even internalized programming, so that you can be you. Te wāna, tāua, te awa. If you would like to listen to more messages from us, please subscribe to this YouTube channel. We offer regular updates each month. You can also find these channeled papers, a comprehensive archive including Gaia and humanity's galactic history, and so much more at the website ascensionearth.com. Thank you.